Hello Year 7, and welcome to our Summer Celebration Assembly. I'm going to attempt to use my newfound technology skills throughout. So I'm going to be down here narrating through each slide, hopefully going to do Mrs. Broadrip proud. So if you want to pause here for a second and go and get some snacks, it's going to be a long one because we've got a lot to celebrate. Okay, here we go. Hello Year 7 and welcome to our Summer Celebration Assembly and our last assembly of the year. I just want to say how incredibly proud I am of all of your achievements this year and a huge well done to all of you that have won an award. I look forward to seeing you in September. It felt fitting for me to introduce the video from the hall. Obviously that is where our assemblies normally are, and it was very, very sad actually being in there kind of without you guys. So I'm really looking forward to September so that we can eventually kind of start getting back to normality and I'll be able to see you again. So some of our outstanding lockdown work. I've been so impressed just across all subjects with the work that you've been producing. So here is a few bits of artwork. It's absolutely fantastic. Some language work. Some French there. I'm not going to even attempt to speak French. When I come into your French lessons, I always attempt a little bit. And it's something I really regret, actually, never taking a language. And I do a lot of traveling and I do always try and learn a few key words. But you guys just amaze me with how amazing you are with your language work. So well done, and really keep it up, because as an adult, as I say, when you're traveling around, when you go on holiday, it's such a key skill to be able to understand and interact with the locals. Some humanities work. The historic menu, I was a big fan looking through that. As you all know, I enjoy my food. Yorkshire pudding there is a main, big fan. And then we've got some nice logos over here as well that you've produced. 5, 6, 7, 8. I have to be honest, I've watched this video a few times just because I kept getting distracted by the little bunny at the back there that's hopping around. Also, I just want to say a Mrs. Hinch inspired garden there. Big fan of the heart at the back and that egg chair. I really want to get one for my own garden. So amazing dance work. But I had to watch it a few times because I kept getting distracted by all of the things going on in the background there. So at the Head Teacher Awards, the next slide is going to be Mrs. Oakley, and then we'll see who has been lucky enough to win a Head Teacher Award in this last half term and since Christmas.
Hi everyone, I just wanted to say a few words to start your celebration assembly, the end one of this whole year, and what a year it's been. So we couldn't have thought of a different way to end this year. 18 weeks of lockdown now we've done, lots of home learning for you, but you have also, and well done everybody, joined in the quizzes, the competitions, our charity events, the house competition, and if your celebration is sort of the end of next, so the beginning of next week, then you'll know who's won the house championship. If not, if it's Thursday and Friday of this last final week, then we're still waiting, aren't we? So fingers crossed to everybody and every single house. So congratulations to you all. It doesn't matter that this is a celebration assembly and that some of you might win certificates or whatever. All of you are winners. 160,000 e-reps have been sent out, 5,000 electronic department postcards, loads of postcards home as well. So, you know, huge amount that has come your way. Awards evening, if you were lucky to have one of these certificates and awards nominated by your subject leaders. But if not, as I said, everybody's a winner, and hopefully you'll have received something to say well done, because each and every one of you needs to be proud of your achievements over this lockdown period. And so, because I don't want to take up all the time in this assembly, just a few things to think about as we move into a lovely summer holiday, and hopefully the sun will shine too. As it says in that little artist drawing and information that Charlie Maxey does so well, it is all about strength and love, and it is all about being brave and achieving more than we could ever dream to achieve. And you have done that, all of you. And also, as he says here, you know, the storm clouds will pass by, and it looks like for September they have done. Fingers crossed that nothing changes, because we cannot wait to see you come September. It's going to be very, very special. And so, to leave you with, let's make sure that you are, like always, kind, courageous, be curious, still go outside, still look around, be thoughtful, everybody, because there is still coronavirus out there, and some people in our community are still extremely worried about it, as we all should be. We should all make sure that we are following that social distancing guidance. So make some wise choices, be kind, and I can't wait to see you in September. It's going to be a very special few days when you're all back in and we are all together again. So take care till then.
Thank you, Mrs. Oakley. So for the Head Teacher Awards, this is for outstanding contribution across these different subject areas. Could be that you have made exceptional progress in this subject, but you have stood out to your teachers, and so therefore you have won these awards. So big well done. I'll leave that there for a second so you can have a little look at those names. Amazing work. I'm going to keep going because we've got a lot of awards and celebrations to get through. But if you want to pause it there for a second so that you can have a little look at those names at your own time. So, Tutee of the Year. We're going to do these in three parts. We're going to start off with Alba, our house winners, and Bedford.
Hello Year 7. Picking Tutee of the Year for 7A1 has been really tricky because there are so many brilliant students. I have chosen someone that is always polite, puts in 100% effort into all of their work, and gets involved with tutor activities as well. This student has also contributed to several charity events throughout the year, including the clothes collection, the Rotary Shoebox Appeal, and the food bank collection. On top of all of this, this student currently has the highest EREF score in 7A1. 7A1's Tutee of the Year is Amber Knight.
Well done, Amber. So, 7A2.
Hello, 7A2. I thought it was apt to do this in front of my bookshelves because we've been reading so much over the last few months. So firstly, our Tutee of the Year is going to be somebody who has done absolutely fantastically with the positive EREFs, has never had a negative all year, has been reading like a trooper for our reading tracker, and has taken part in every single tutor activity that I've been putting up. So he is a fantastic member of the team. I don't think he'll even think that he could be in with a chance of winning this because he is so quiet and just keeps himself to himself and is so conscientious and hardworking. But the person who is our Tutee of the Year is Elliot Buckingham. So well done to you.
Well done, Elliot. And just an amazing bookshelf. I've got envy here. I think I'm looking at my bookshelf over in the corner. I'm thinking, I need to jazz up a little bit like that. So well done, Elliot. B1.
Okay, so my Tutee of the Year is somebody who is incredibly kind and polite and always tries his best in lessons and in tutor time. I think he's coped really well during lockdown. He's achieved loads of greens and golds, which is amazing. And I think the standout moment for me was when he brought in 26 items for the basics bank, and then that kind of encouraged all the other tutees to bring in lots of items too. So my Tutee of the Year is James Bainbridge.
Amazing. Well done, James. And 26 items. It's absolutely incredible. So big well done to you. And 7B2.
Like other tutors have said and will say, this is genuinely a really tricky decision to make. There are people in the group, I'm lucky enough to say, who've shone academically. Others who've been so amazingly involved with sport, dance and music all year. others who have volunteered as school librarians, and those that have repeatedly stepped up to volunteer for house events. You know who you are, so congratulations to all of you. 7B2's tutee of the year has always been the first to consider others, even when she is facing challenges herself. She has baked cake after cake for school bake sales, brought in can after can for the food bank appeal, and during lockdown has managed to produce great schoolwork whilst at the same time raising a whopping £400 for Southampton General Hospital's paediatric intensive care unit by making hammer beads and badges and selling them on her driveway. I'm pleased to announce the 7B2's tutee of the year for 2019-20 goes to Lucy Spur. Congratulations, Lucy.
Amazing work, Lucy, and I've been so impressed with your entrepreneur skills and creating things and selling them obviously for charity. So amazing work, Lucy, really, really well deserved as tutee of the year. So some more outstanding work.
Hello, I'm Dylan Harfield and welcome to the weather. Thursday going into Friday, there will be rain and possibly thunder for most areas of the UK. Breaking up on Friday morning shouldn't be so bad as the sun should come straight out. Although in the evening, it is most likely for it to be quite cold and windy. Leading into the weekend, it will still be very wet in northeast areas and bring a little bit of a breeze in the southern parts. Saturday is still very dry, although it may bring some wind with it. Sunday should then be much better as the rain and thunder drifts away from these northern areas. It should also be much warmer and brighter all over the UK. Throughout the most of the upcoming week, we'll just get nice, lovely sun, warm, bright weather, and yes, that's it for today.
Well done, Dylan. I really do hope that we are going to get lots and lots of sun over the summer. We definitely deserve it so that we can go out in the garden and go for lovely walks. So fingers crossed for that. But here is some other amazing geography work. And we've got some more humanities here. And some more artwork. And I just have to say, Emily Horlock, wow, what absolutely, the one that's just above my head here, what an absolutely fantastic piece of art. I'm really looking forward to seeing what you do over the next few years in your art lessons. And some science. You might want to pause here for a second and read this piece of work just over here. I've read it a few times and each time it has really made me laugh because it's all about the digestive system and it's essentially a piece of pizza and its journey through the digestive system. It's just really clever, really funny. So you might want to pause here for a second and just give that a read. So on to subject awards. This is for exceptional effort or progress, and you've really shown your subject teachers what fantastic work you can do. So English, big well done to everybody on there. The Creative Writing House Competition, Emily Horlock, first place, and then runners up, Hannah Johnson and Sophie White, well done to you. Our Maths Awards. Science. And it was Maria's work that we saw a few slides back there, the piece of pizza work. So well done to Maria. Humanities. So this is across geography, history and RE. A big well done to everybody on there. ICT. I'm covering a name down here. I'll get back to you and I'll let you know whose name my head is covering. Well done to everyone on there. Arts. So this is art, music, dance and drama. Big well done to everybody on there. Languages. You can just about see here, this is Reese Wellgreen. That's who I'm covering. design and technology. So this is across your wood lessons, your textiles and food technology. PE. So I'm covering Shannon Travers and Aidan just there. Well done to everybody on that list. And the Epic Awards. So this is for an outstanding contribution to the creative and media subjects for your extracurricular activities. So we've got some dance on there, some drama, people that have gone to obviously drama club and art. So a huge well done for your Epic Award. So some more Tutti of the Year. We've now got Driscoll and Jubilee.
So my nomination for 7D1 is James Clark. And the reason why I'm nominating James is that he has consistently worked well this year, and I don't feel like he's always recognised as much as he should be. He's not the student in the class with the highest E-refs. However, I know that he's working very, very hard, and he's put himself out there to be a student librarian at the start of the year, which I think shows a real dedication to extracurricular activities. So well done, James. You've been fantastic.
Well done, James, the winner of Tutti of the Year for 7D1. So we've now got Miss Clifton with 7D2.
So just before I start, I just want to let you guys know that this decision was so hard, and I honestly could have given this award to each and every one of you. And that's the truth. I'm not just saying that, okay? But the person that I have decided to give this award to is someone who, without fail, will always come into tutor with a great big bubbly smile on their face each morning, which just makes me smile even more, which is just fantastic. But this person will always get involved in each and every tutor session, and they will always, always help others. And that's something I really do notice a lot in tutor especially. They are always keen and offering to help other members of our tutor and me, which is just such a lovely, lovely quality to have. And it just goes so noticed and really is appreciated. This person also gets involved in lots of the house competitions, loads of extracurricular after school activities, and has also created the most amazing paintings since lockdown. I didn't realize I had so many artists in my tutor group. Obviously you guys are so creative anyway, but these paintings are just on another level. It's just absolutely fantastic. And this person just overall is just such a lovely, positive role model, and she truly deserves this award. So my Tutti of the Year award goes to Gabby Martin.
A huge well done to you, Gabby. I'm lucky enough to have Gabby in my drama class, and I have to agree with everything that Miss Clifton's just said. Always comes to the lesson with a massive smile on her face, and it's infectious. It always makes me smile. The fact she always says goodbye and hello, you know, things like that really do mean a lot to us. So a huge well done to you, Gabby. J1.
My Tutti of the Year nomination was such a hard decision. Firstly, given them a slight disadvantage because I haven't really got to know you much, but I've had a chat with Mrs. Miles, and also I've had a look at all of the work that you've been submitting over lockdown, and it still was a really hard decision. I looked at all the parent conversations that I've been having, and every single one of them was positive. They're all so, so proud of you. So that made it even more difficult. But the one person that I would like to nominate as my Tutti of the Year is Freddie Brown. That is because he's always smiling whenever he comes into the classroom. He's kept up to date with all of his work, and his teachers have all been so impressed with all of the work that he's submitted so far. So well done, Freddie. Congratulations, you are my Tutti of the Year. Well done.
Well done, Freddie. And 7J2.
Hello, 7J2. It was a very difficult decision to decide my Tutti of the Year, as there were four or five students to choose from that really stood out this year. This person, though, has done incredibly well in terms of the number of E-refs they've received throughout the year. They work very hard in their lessons and often go a little bit under the radar, I think. They have contributed greatly to all of the charity events, especially the Basics Bank and the Shoebox Appeal in particular. This person gets involved in every Tutor Time session, doing really well normally in all of our cahoots and especially the countdown games. I think this person is looked up to by the rest of the tutor as well, and I think that's why They're the perfect example to be our first tutee of the year, and that is Florence Latter. Well done, Flo.
Well done, Flo. Excellent work. Okay, so some more outstanding lockdown work. And the next two videos are from drama. Now, you will know in drama, you were asked to make a lip sync video to Grease because we were studying musical theatre. These two videos in particular have made me laugh so much. The first one by Amelia Sutton, which is just so creative and just completely thinking outside of the box. And then the second one, the dedication to the two different characters just made me laugh. So here we go, first of all, with Amelia's. Just amazing. Such clever and creative work. So huge well done. And our second one is Liam.
Summer loving had me a blast.
Summer loving happened so fast.
Excellent work, Liam. So we've got ICT. Examples of really creative work. So our attendance awards. This is awarded to the students that have had 100% attendance for the entire year. And we're running this up until February because obviously that's when things start to go a little bit crazy. So this is from September to February with 100% attendance. Now, I don't have 100% attendance. There are lots and lots of members of staff that also don't have 100% attendance because, you know, we get ill and sometimes we, you know, we wake up and we're not feeling 100%, but these students have been in every single day. And I think that's absolutely incredible. So if your name is on this slide, a really, really massive well done to you. So move me out of the way for a second. So you can see the names there. Put myself over here for a second. Well done to everybody on there. So we have got some more tutees of the year. So we have got P1, P2, S1 and S2.
I've nominated this person for tutee of the year as throughout the year they've worked hard in all their subjects, getting a huge number of E-refs. This has continued through lockdown and they've maintained an effort despite not being in school. When we were at school, they were always volunteering and helping out in form time, and they always put themselves forward for the house championship, earning some well-deserved points for Paxton House. Congratulations to my tutee of the year, Nina Wijnan.
Well done, people.
Big well done to Nina. Nina has got involved in absolutely everything this year, so thoroughly, thoroughly deserved. 7P2.
So 7P2, tutee of the year, Daphne Isabel Holloway. Isabel is always positive and a lot to have in the tutee group and always gets involved in outside competitions. She also has a massive interest in history, especially in the Tudors. So well done, Isabella.
Well done, Isabella Holloway. Now is a good chance for us to stop for a second and say a huge, huge thank you to Mr. Byrne for everything he's done this year with 7P2. Sadly, he is moving on. So we wish you the best of luck and we welcome Mr. Theobald, who is going to be our new tutor in year 8. So thank you, Mr. Byrne, and welcome to Mr. Theobald. 7S1.
7S1, I have picked this person to be my tutee of the year as they have shown resilience throughout the year. They have been interested and gotten stuck into so many things, including during tutor time, during lesson time, after school, during school, wherever they could get involved, they were getting involved. Charity fundraising was also fantastic, bringing in loads of items for the food drive and in our recycled clothes. I have picked this person as I believe they have been all around amazing throughout the year, as well as everything else. So Poppy Lacey, I have picked you as my tutee of the year. Keep up all of the amazing hard work and I can't wait to see what you do in year 8. So well done.
Well done, Poppy. And 7S2.
What a difficult decision. I'm very, very lucky to have such a kind, determined and resilient tutor group. And it was really tricky for me to choose someone. But the person that has stood out for me is someone that from day one has been kind and caring and always happy to help other people. And I think that's a really important attribute to have. This person has shown great determination in all aspects of school life, throwing himself into everything and anything that is available. And I've been approached by many teachers who have been just so positive about this person's attitude and application in the classroom. So my tutee of the year is Callum.
Well done, Callum. Okay, so the E-Ref Awards. These first ones is all of these students have had no negative E-Refs at all this year, which you'll see, this is just slide one. There's some more names here. And I think it's absolutely incredible that you've never forgotten your kit, so you haven't had an amber for that. You've always had your plan assigned. You know, all of these small little things that perhaps you could have got an amber E-Ref for. You guys have clearly been absolutely on it. And there's another page to receive no negatives. So I think that is absolutely amazing and a huge, huge well done to you guys. So moving on to our bronze awards. So this is 200 plus E-Refs and you will see, again, we've got a few pages there. So well done to everybody on the bronze award. We have the silver award. So this is if you've had more than 350 E-Refs. And again, we've got a couple of pages of names there. And I just want to say that this is because we had to have a cutoff point. I know some of you are probably going, oh, well, I've got more than that. The cutoff point was actually last week. So if, you know, you've had another week of picking up E-Refs, that's amazing. But obviously I had to have a cutoff point so that I had time to put everything together. So a massive well done to you guys. The gold award. This is 450 plus EFs, and we have got lots and lots of names for this one. So again, you might want to pause if you want to and just double check if your name is on there. A huge well done to you guys. The Platinum Award, which is 600 plus EREF points, which is just incredible. And again, we have got lots and lots of names for the Platinum Award. And then we have a new award because over lockdown, there's been lots of EREFs that have been handed out. And we thought, actually, some of you have got such incredible EREF scores that we have created a new award for you guys. And that is the Diamond Award. So absolutely incredible. The fact that we've got, and Nina, I know you would have picked up at least two more points, so you'll definitely be on 1,000 by now. But the fact that we've got some people on over 1,000 EREFs, I have never ever seen that during my time at Wildern, and I'm not sure we'll ever see that again. So if you guys are on here for the Diamond Award, absolutely incredible. A huge, huge well done to you guys. So a message from the hashtag Team Year 7 Tutors.
Hello 7A1, can you believe it? You've already completed your first year at Wildern. I just wanted to say well done for all of the hard work that you have been completing this year, both in school and during lockdown. I also wanted to mention how impressed I have been with your involvement with the house events and the charity events that have taken place this year, and the fantastic EREF scores that I've been seeing every single week. So well done. I hope that this will carry on next year and perhaps Alba can be the house champions again for the third year in a row. It has been a strange year, but you have all shown resilience and I am really proud to be your tutor. I hope you all have a fantastic summer and I'm really looking forward to seeing you again in September for the start of year 8. See you soon.
7A2, I just want to say how fantastically proud I am to be your tutor. We have absolutely annihilated the competition. We have absolutely smashed the positive EREFs, and you are fantastic at getting involved in every single house competition that we have taken part in. So I really, really, really want this to continue all the way through to year 11. Let's keep smashing it. Let's keep annihilating the competition and let's keep being the best that we can be. We are the dream team because we work hard, we are kind, and because of that, good things do happen to us. So well done, keep it up, and I can't wait to see you all in September.
My message to 7B1 is well done on such an amazing year. I think you've coped really well considering you're joining secondary school, global pandemic, lockdown for 4 months. I think you've done brilliantly. You should all be really proud of yourself for all the greens and golds that you've had. Enjoy your summer break. It's well deserved. Rest lots. If you're going away, have an amazing time and take care. And I can't wait to see you in September. Lots of coots and birthdays to catch up on.
Hello 7B2. This feels a bit like a Eurovision Song Contest announcement, though I haven't dressed up in sequins and I couldn't find a flag to wave, so sorry. It's been a brilliant year in so many ways for you. I've loved getting to know you guys and have really missed not seeing you every morning. You might be surprised by that, however. And having to stop Finn and Ryan's football banter getting out of hand or laughing at Matthew's terrible jokes and being told off by Nicole and Phoebe for not reminding them of something or other. I imagine, though, when I see you in September, you'll be a great deal wiser and some of you will be a little bit taller. However, in the meantime, have a wonderful summer. Be good, be safe. Be ready to come back to school in September with all the energy you can muster. See you then.
Hi, 71. So here's my message for you. Right from the beginning, I knew that you were a lovely bunch of students and you've proved yourself to be entertaining, hardworking, and caring. And although we haven't won every competition this year, you've really pulled together well as a tutor group, right from the Hilliers trip at the start of term, to the shoebox appeal, to giving to charity with the Basics Bank. And I know that you have worked really, really hard this year. I know it hasn't been easy in lockdown. I know some of you have struggled with the work. Some of you have been incredibly independent. However you found it, take it as a learning experience, and we're going to push forward next year in year eight. I can't believe you're going to be year eight, but I'm really looking forward to seeing you and to see what the future brings. Have a lovely summer and take care of yourselves and your families.
Hi 72, I hope you're all okay and well, and you're all looking after your friends and families. And I know you would have done this though, because you're all lovely, lovely people. And honestly, I just want to say how wonderful it's been to get to know each and every one of you this year. We've shared our first year at Wildern together, and I want to thank you for making it the best year for me. Honestly, it's been amazing, and we've shared some fantastic times together. Obviously, circumstances have certainly been different lately, and I know it must have been especially tough for you guys being in year seven, but I just want you to know how proud I am of each and every one of you. Just hearing about a few of the new skills that you've learned, the achievements throughout lockdown, and just seeing your work that you've completed, it's been absolutely fantastic, and I just couldn't be any more proud of you as a tutor. So thank you so much for this, and I'm just so happy that you're stuck with me for another four more years, yay! But no, I miss you guys so much. I miss our Bears days. I miss you rinsing me for my sweets every day. I miss trying to talk at the board and you just doing all these dance moves and driving me crazy. But I just miss seeing your happily bubbly faces each day. And I can't wait to see you guys again soon. So just take care of yourselves until
then. Hello 71, I just want to take this opportunity to tell you what a fantastic tutor group you are. It was lovely getting to meet you all right before lockdown, and I've been so, so impressed with your commitment, resilience and your positivity throughout lockdown. It's going to stand you in good stead for the future, and it's really nice to see all the positivity that I've had come from your parents when I've had conversations with them on the phone. They've all been so positive about all of the work that you've been completing, and they've been really, really proud of you, so well done. I can't wait to see you all in September when you move into year 8 and I can get to know you a bit better and you can get to know me a little bit better, and we can move forward and be the best tutor group that we can be. I hope you have a fantastic summer, and I can't wait to hear about all the exciting things that you're up to.
Hello 7J2. I hope you're all really well and keeping yourselves and your family safe during this time. I know this year has been really different to normal, and I know it's been very difficult for some of you in particular, but congratulations on making it through. Well done, you've got to the end of your first year at Wildern. It's my first year at Wildern as well, and I just wanted to thank you all for being such a lovely first tutor group to have. You guys have been fantastic, and I just couldn't wait to come into school every morning to see you guys. I've been so proud of some of the achievements we've had together as well, especially the Basics Bank. The amount of food you guys brought in and donated was honestly unbelievable. I was so proud when we were walking down to the dark with all those boxes of food and you guys just carrying them between you. Honestly, I'll never forget that day. It was fantastic. I hope that you guys have a really good time off now for the summer. I hope you stay safe. Make sure you keep your family safe as well, and enjoy the time you have earned off. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.
To say how proud I am of everyone, how well you've been working at home, how you've taken all of this into your stride, and you're all coping very well. Very much looking forward to September when we can have a proper catch-up face-to-face. I want to hear all the fun and exciting things you've done over the summer holidays when you have a little bit of a rest from doing some work. Very much looking forward to seeing all of you soon. Take care and all of the best.
So 7P2, this is it. This is goodbye. I just want to say thank you for the year. You've been fantastic. And also to continue what you're doing, really. You've all been doing great. And if you keep that up, the rewards will come at the end of year 11. So yeah, this is goodbye. And yeah, just be good for the next year as well as you've been for me.
Hi 7S1. What a year. And what a strange end to the year as well. But you have done it. You've made it all the way through your first year at Wildern. As you can see, I am in our tutor base. I have updated it, ready for when you come back in September. Year 8. Oh my gosh, you're going to be year 8. That's crazy. A year has gone. Right from the beginning, when we had our transition in that summer, when I first met you, I could see you all so excited and ready to join, and you've settled in so, so well. And I'm so proud of each and every single one of you. I'm really proud to call you my tutor group. Over the lockdown especially, there's been a lot of collaboration, a lot of you getting involved, and it's so lovely to see all the pictures that you're sending me from home. I am really, really proud. I want you to keep it up all the way until that Wednesday. But make sure you have yourselves a really, really lovely, safe, relaxing summer holidays fresh for September.
7S2, what a year it has been. Definitely one that we will not forget in a hurry. I just wanted to say how proud I am of all of you for how brilliantly you've adapted to all the different hurdles that you've had to face in year seven. And the resilience that you've shown, I'm sure, will stay with you forever. So have a fantastic summer. Enjoy your well-deserved break, whatever your plans are and wherever you might travel to. Please look after yourselves and I cannot wait to see you soon.
I would just like to take the time now to say a huge, huge thank you to the whole entire team of tutors. We are so, so lucky to have these guys as our tutors. You are so lucky to have them as your tutors. And I think when we get back, you know, really, really take that time to perhaps appreciate your tutor, because they are there every single day. They are that face, that constant face that you see. And they put in a lot of hard work behind the scenes, which I think maybe sometimes you guys don't quite realise. You think, oh, I see them for that half an hour in the morning and then that's it. Actually, you know, they are really looking out for you throughout the entire school year and in the future. So just take a second, just reflect, just think about how lucky you are to have your amazing tutor, and make sure that next year you really, really do show them your appreciation. So thank you from me to all of the tutors. You are fantastic and I am very, very lucky to work with such incredible people. So the year group awards. Now this is something a little bit different. We don't normally do this. Me and all of the tutor team were talking and we thought, you know what? Actually, there's some in particular, you know, particular students we would like to highlight for various different reasons. So the first one is the funniest boy nominations. So if you've been nominated, you've clearly made your tutor or myself laugh a lot this year. So our winner, and you will see why in a little bit, is Jack B. I've been lucky enough to teach Jack actually as well this year in drama, and he's always coming up with something funny. But in particular, the highlight for I think everyone was Celebration Assembly, and that was the Christmas Celebration Assembly. And you'll see what I mean in a minute. But Jack, hilarious, keep it up. Funniest girl. So these are our funny ladies who have made their tutors laugh this year. And our winner is Lily Noyce. So well done, Lily. Kindest boy. And this was a really, really tough one because actually everybody on this list deserves to win. That's why you've been nominated. But our winner as the kindest boy is Aidan Bishop. So a big well done to you, Aidan. The kindest girl. And again, this one was a really, really, really tough call to make. But the kindest girl is Eleanor Manning. So well done to you. Smiliest. And you can see this list is quite long because there's lots and lots of you that are always super smiley, always say hello around school. But our smiliest is Amelie Horlock. And actually, I'm not sure I've ever seen you without a smile on your face, Amelie. So keep that up. Most curious. So this is students that perhaps in tutor and in their lessons are asking questions. Perhaps they are somebody that actually the work in lesson is not enough for them and they want to go away and they want to do some of their own research and perhaps they've spoken to their class teachers and asked for some extension work. And I cannot think of anyone better to receive this award than Emily Heath. I know she has done lots and lots of extra work this year in subjects. So a huge well done to you, Emily. Most charitable. Now again, I am so, so lucky to have such a charitable year group. And the Basics Bank and the Shoebox Appeal just proved that, you know, the most Basic Bank items that any year group has ever bought in. So you guys are absolutely amazing. And our winner is Caleb. So a huge well done to you. Let's see year seven, if next year we can beat that. So let's see if we can bring in even more Basics Bank because we have set the bar up here and now we need to sustain that. We need to keep it going. So well done. Most Improved. Now, I had to choose two for this one because I just couldn't pick. Now, one of them I have, they have won because actually they will admit themselves, they really struggled at the beginning of the year and they found even just coming into school a challenge. So a huge well done to them because they have come on leaps and bounds. And, you know, I've seen them around school smiling, happy and just cracking on with things. The other person has actually really, really impressed me over lockdown, simply because, you know, the standard of work they've handed in has been brilliant. And I'm pretty certain they've handed in every single piece of work that has been set for them. So our two winners are Florence and Pablo. A huge well done to you guys. And the DOPA Award. And again, I've chosen two people for this award, two different reasons. So the first person has really impressed me this year, actually, but mostly during lockdown, because they have handed in every single piece of work. They have been absolutely on it with the e-refs and they have been so charitable. For the sack race, they raised over £100 for charity. So absolutely incredible work. Our second person, we've been very, very lucky because they started with us late. We managed to steal them from Wyvern. And wow, what an incredible person you have been in the year group. I know for a fact that when we had the elders lunch, you stood out to them as somebody that was just being really kind and helpful and making them laugh. And every time I see you around school, you say hello to me and you crack a joke and you're just so kind and considerate. So I'm really glad we managed to steal you from Ivan. So our winners for the DOPA Award is Emily Yates and Harry Still. And I just want to say again how impressed I've been with you two this year. And amazing work. Keep it up. Well done. So the big awards. These are the ones we're waiting for. Who is on top? So tutor group attendance in last place is 7J2. Then it's D1. P1, B2, P2, B1, and look how close some of these numbers are. It was such a tough call. D2, A2, S1. So that means in third place is A1. In second place is J1. And in first place, I'm going to move myself just to confirm. We have got 7S2 in first place with 97.52%. So absolutely incredible. You guys are in school. You are getting on with things, even maybe when you're not feeling 100%. So well done. E-refs. A1. P2. D2, S2, S1, and these numbers, again, so, so close. There's only a handful of golds in it with some of these. So in third place is B1, 15,000. That's absolutely insane amount of EREFs. Second place is J2, and in first place, 7A2, and A2 have been in the lead for the entire year. I didn't think anyone was going to catch them. And look at that, 20,000 EREF points. That's insane. That's absolutely insane. I've never seen that before. So 7A2, you should be so proud of yourself. And I know you refer to yourself as the dream team. And I have to say, I can see why you're the dream team now. But let's see if the rest of you guys can up your game and take them on in year 8. And this is the total amount of EREF points for just for year 7 this year. Absolutely incredible. So this is where I'm going to part ways. I've got a little video for you just to finish off, which is kind of your year 7 best bits, some of the highlights from this year. And I've watched it quite a few times now when I was putting it together, and it still makes me really emotional. And when I say emotional, I mean because I'm so overwhelmed with just how proud of you guys I am. This has not been the easiest year seven at all. It's not been the easiest year for any year group, but especially in your first year when you're just joining secondary school, just when you've got your feet under the table and you knew where you were going and you understood everything, bam. Global pandemic, and it kind of has shaken things up a little bit. But you guys have been so resilient and creative, and just the work that you have handed in over this time has been amazing. So you should be really, really proud of yourself. And I want you to really reflect over the summer on just how well you've done, because I think some of you just kind of crack on with it and maybe you don't realize just what a good job you're doing. So a massive well done from me. You deserve a very restful and relaxing summer. Take care of yourself, look after your family, and be ready and raring to go in year eight, because we are going to hit the ground running. We are going to aim to be even better than we were in year seven. We're going to be even more charitable, even more kind, and even more considerate. So I'm going to head off and I'm going to leave you with this video. Thank you for everything you have done this year, and I cannot wait to see you in year eight. Well done. Bye.
Gotcha.